Hello everyone, today we will continue to study how to play with the isolated pawn. I would like to show you a game which was played by two world champions. Vasily Smyslov played with the white pieces and Anatoly Karpov played with the black pieces. This game was played in Leningrad 50 years ago in 1971. In the USSR championship. So Smyslov started with c4, c5, so it started as an English opening. Knight f3, knight f6, knight c3, d5, c takes d5, knight takes d5, e3. Yeah, white plays very solid chess, as black also plays very safe. e6 d4 c takes d4 e takes d4 bishop e7. Actually we transposed to Panov-Botvinnik attack, which can come out of the Karokan defense, but this kind of positions can appear also from the Nimzo-Indian defense, the Rubinstein variation. Bishop d3, nice developing moves of both colors. Castle knight c6, rook e1, knight f6. Here actually the other common move is bishop f6, with the idea of playing with knight c2 e7 to build up a perfect blockade on the d5 square against the d4 isolated pawn. When you play with the isolated pawn, you try to use the extra space which it provides for building up an active position and then attack the opponent king. Also many times you can use those squares controlled by the isolated pawn to build up nice outposts for knights, and always need to have the mind to push the pawn to try to even open more the position for your active pieces. So black played knight f6 here. Black may plans to play here knight b4, knight d5 to build up a blockade against the d4 pawn. So white played a3, this is a good move to prevent the knight b4. b6, preparing the development of the bishop. Bishop c2. White prepares to build up a strong cannon against the black king with the bishop c2 and then queen d3. Here actually the best move is bishop a6 to prevent the queen d3 move and then continue the development with rook c8, even maybe bishop d5 and bishop c4, bishop d5 can be also a good idea in the future to build up the blockade against the d4 pawn. Here black played the usual bishop b7 move and queen d3. Nice attacking position. Here actually black made a mistake, rook c8. The better move would be here to play g6. Need to play immediately, neutralize that attack. Bishop h6, rook e8, rook hd1. And the position is kind of balanced. Probably white has a small development advantage and space advantage. Instead, Karpov played the natural developing move rook c8, which actually a mistake. Smyslov did not use that mistake, but d5 would be a very powerful move. Because if pawn captures on d5, then there's a nice and strong continuation. Please pause the video and try to find a good move for white. Okay, so bishop g5 is the good move, certainly bishop takes f6 and then queen takes h7 checkmate. And after g6, another nice move comes, please try to find it. Yeah, this exchange sacrifice wins because after queen takes seven, knight takes d5. And the next move will come, knight takes f6 check. White has two pieces against the rook and a very strong attacking position. which provides the victory. I trusted d5, probably the best move is knight a5, but still here. White is very active. Bishop g5, the best chance for black to sacrifice the exchange to distract the queen. Queen takes c3, queen takes d5, rook c1, h6, bishop e3, and yeah, white has the exchange advantage for 1 pawn, which is still a pretty good advantage for white. So this would be powerful. But instead of d5, as we said before, you always need to be ready for pushing the isolated pawn to open up the position. Like, one of the key ideas of this move is to actually open up the e-file for the rook. So bishop g5, I played g6 to block the attack on the h7 pawn, rook d1, knight d5. The player who plays against the isolated pawn try to exchange pieces, because in the end game the isolated pawn can be a target, so we would like to avoid the exchange. So bishop h6, bishop e8, so rook e8, bishop. The bishop on c2 has now not big future anymore because it's blocked by the g6 pawn. So bishop a4 to reposition to an active square. a6, knight takes d5, transformational move. If he takes d5, then white would go b4, b5, bishop b3, attacking the d5 pawn and having a more active position. But black captured actually the queen, which probably was even the worst possibility, because after now queen e3 is an important move, protecting the h6 bishop, and now preparing the break with bishop b3 and d5. Bishop f6 looks like kind of like a good defensive move, but here comes bishop b3, queen h5, and yeah, there is no good way to block the advance of the pawn. And one other important fact here is the situation of the queen and the rook on e1. Black cannot take this pawn, because then this would lead to a checkmate. So this is the other reason why d5 is very strong, because actually black cannot capture it. Knight d8. Yeah, and white just pushed the pawn. Now the isolated pawn became a very strong pass pawn. Rook c5, d7, rook e7, queen f4, ready to penetrate. Bishop g7, queen b8, queen takes h6, queen takes d8. Bishop f8, rook e3, yeah, ready to recapture with the rook on f3, bishop c6, and here white can just go and win a piece. Please try to find a way how white finished the game. Queen takes c8, queen takes d8, queen, and because now white is up a piece, Karpov resigned. I wish you got a few new ideas from this game, which you will be able to put into practice in your own games. Yeah, thank you for watching. See you soon.